guys, welcome to HipHughes History. What I want to do in this mini lecture is I want to propose a question to you. A lot of times in an American history course or in a government course, you could be in middle school, you could be in high school, you could be in college, but you're going to get this question. And it's a great question. Why do federal judges get lifetime terms? Nobody else gets a lifetime job. Who the hell gets a lifetime job? Like, you're hired forever. My goodness. Well, there's a reason. So I'm going to explain that reason, and then I'm going to ask you to comment below and to tell me, should judges have to face voters? Everybody else has to face voters? Everybody else has to go and say, please elect me. Let me tell you why. But not a federal judge, not a Supreme Court judge. They could sit up there forever. They could be the worst judges ever. And unless they get impeached, which is a very rare thing, they got a job for life. A job for life! I want a job for life! So why? Why jobs for life? Well, I can argue this, and I can be really persuasive. What is a judge in the federal court system doing? What does a Supreme Court judge do? Right? They interpret the Constitution, right? They look at the words, they decide what they mean, and they decide whether, you know, executive actions or laws are constitutional. That's a tremendous power, this power of judicial review. So why give them lifetime terms? Let me think. Maybe because the masses are asses. Maybe because you don't want them worrying about whether or not they're going to get reelected because they decide that somebody's equal that wasn't equal before. Maybe if we had Brown versus Board, think about this, Brown versus Board of Ed, the famous decision, right? Thurgood Marshall, NAACP, goes to the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court decides that the 14th Amendment's language of equality means that separate is not equal, right? That you can't have segregation, first in schools and later in Jim Crow life, but that this violates the Constitution, the very essence of the 14th Amendment of equal protection under the law. Now think about it. What if those judges had to face re-election? What if they had to think, man, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna make sure that I rule for equality and then go get reelected, what, in Mississippi? So, lifetime terms insulate judges, insulate the Supreme Court from public opinion. So it's not about which way is breezing in the wind, but what the Constitution inherently says and means. And now, is there kind of democracy in how the judges get there? Sure there is, right? Don't you kind of use the Electoral College to choose electors, to choose the president, who chooses the judges, who go in front of the Senate with 17th Amendment, where you choose your senators to ratify the judges? So there you go. But is that enough? Is it enough that judges just kind of have this impeachment check and balance, but otherwise they don't have to worry about what the people think, right? Would we have a different decision on Obamacare, on affirmative action, on the death penalty, on all of these, on abortion, on these big public policy issues if judges had to face the voters? So you tell me, should judges have to face voters, or should judges enjoy lifetime terms? That's the question that I pose for you. Let's see what you think. And don't forget to subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, you gotta click Noam Chomsky. Click him right now, because if you click him, you'll get like one magic wish. You're not gonna get a magic wish, guys, but you should click him anyway. And make sure you check the description below, because there's a whole bunch of other EDU gurus that you have to check out like right now, and EDU geniuses. Have you watched Vsauce, ViHeart, like Minute Physics, Smarter Every Day? You haven't watched Smarter Every Day. You'd be getting smarter every day.